Emma, Thames Theatre, what's going on today?
As you can see, we're just setting up for a press conference. We've got the national press launch for the European elections being held in Thurrock today. We're going to be launching our manifesto, our policies, and talking about what we've been doing for the campaign.
June the 4th, is this going to be a date where nobody really takes any notice, or do you think the public will get on board?
I think they'll get on board this year. In the past, I think that the European elections haven't really meant much, but we've had quite a while now where people have had a chance to see what it means being part of Europe. There's a lot of scandal going on as well with a lot of the MPs, obviously with expenses, which is really annoying people, and they're determined to go out there, I think, and to make their voices heard, and I believe the way they will do that is by voting for us.
I think it's even a bigger case, the bigger scandal when it actually one day comes out is the MEPs scandal as well, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, we had a while back the problem, obviously, with MEPs turning up, clocking in and leaving again in Europe to claim their expenses. There's so much money being spent and wasted with us being part of Europe. You know, it's costing the taxpayer millions and millions, well, billions of pounds to be part of it, and all we're getting out of it is restrictions on jobs, restrictions on weights and measures, farming restrictions, and there's not anything good coming out of it.
Would you say that your policy, as far as Europe are concerned, are very similar to the UK Independence Party?
I'd say UKIP like to try and copy some of our policies. We mean it, whereas as they don't really know what they want. I mean, we've got a lot of UKIP have already been elected to Europe. There's MEPs there. We haven't seen them make a difference at all. They're there at claiming their expenses, but they're not actually doing anything for people. And that's the difference with us. Once we get in, you'll be able to see that we are doing something for the general public and not just turning up and claiming our expenses, which is what they're doing.
Away from the elections, Thurrock Council.
Yep.
Suddenly you've become a very important person, haven't you, in the last 3 weeks?
I've always been an important person. I think, yeah, obviously with me now holding the balance of power, there's a lot of things going on where I'm actually being noticed. I get to make a lot of decisions in Thurrock with obviously the deciding vote a few weeks ago where I chose to keep the Conservatives in. I think that I've always been outspoken in the chamber. It's obviously not reported that much, but I'll just continue to do what I've always done, and that's the best for the people of Thurrock, regardless of who controls the council.
Sounds to me like you're thriving on the pressure. You're really enjoying this, aren't you?
I always enjoy it. As long as I can do something that makes a difference, then I enjoy myself. And today's going to be a great success. We're going to have media coming from all over the country. And I think they're going to be shocked at the sheer scale of our campaign and being able to see what we're actually doing. And a lot of people, especially in Thurrock, will see in the next few weeks billboards, newspaper ads, online advertising, the broadcast. And they won't know. They're not going to miss us, let's just say.